Hello everyone, thank you all for joining. Once again, welcome to the session. In this workshop, we'll be building an action for Google Assistant. Google Assistant is the voice assistant that we have on all the Android phones as of now. And not just Android phones, we have it as physical devices as well for controlling the home devices. So it's a complete package of voice assistant development. We'll try to develop something in this session. So let's begin. This session is in partnership with MLH. This is in continuation to a lot of workshops that we have been doing, which are all in partnership with MLH. MLH is a nonprofit organization that is having the motto of empowering the hackers all across the globe. You can check them out at mlh.io. So let's understand what we will be building today. First step that we are trying to cover is what exactly is voice assistant and how to build them. Second is we are using Google Cloud Platform for building our voice assistant. And third is using few APIs and mixing them together so as to develop something awesome. The amount of code that needs to be written is not much. It's really less for developing a voice assistant. And that is the cool thing about developing voice assistants. The amount of code you need to write is way less. A lot of work that we need to do is abstracted by these SDKs that Google has provided. So it's easy for people, even those who are beginning with their code journey. What we'll be building today is something known as a sentiment analysis. What we will be doing is we'll be having a topic, let's assume IPL, since it's starting off today, in less than 1.5 hours. So we want to know what is the general sentiment of the people regarding a specific topic. So if we say IPL, are people happy about it? Are people sad about it? Or something along those lines. That is what we are trying to build in this workshop. How does it work? We are going to use something known as Dialogflow. Dialogflow is a service provided from Google where we can develop voice assistant. So it is the development package. And Dialogflow can be used to build not just voice assistants. Your same project can be deployed into a Telegram bot or a Slack bot or an independent voice assistant running on your website. So Dialogflow is a complete service for developing bots and voice assistants. Okay. What is action on? We have voice assistant, which is known as Google Assistant. So the Google Assistant is the voice assistant on Android phones. And action is equivalent to an app on a very basic level. On your phone, you will be having multiple apps. The same way your Google Assistant can have multiple actions. Some of it can be inbuilt, like what's the weather or something along those lines. We can have developers building their own custom action. Like WhatsApp has an action that you tell Google Assistant to send a message via WhatsApp, and it sends through the app you have. So that is an action built by the WhatsApp developers. So action is equivalent to a set of tasks that the voice assistant can do when you have developed something for it. Okay. What we are going to do is going to use Twitter's API. We are using Twitter to find out what people converse about a given topic. So if you are, let's say, talking about IPL as an example, so we will be looking at the tweets regarding the topic IPL. Okay. And then we will be using a natural language processing API. There's nothing that we need to do. There's an API provided by Google Cloud, which does natural language processing. So we give it text, and then it returns the sentiment back to us, like the positiveness in a parameter. So we'll be fetching tweets from Twitter, pushing it to the natural language processing API, and the response of that API, we will be pushing it to the voice assistant. ठीक है। द टूल्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज जावा स्क्रिप्ट। जावा स्क्रिप्ट इज यूज टू डू द एपीआई कॉल्स, वन एपीआई कॉल फॉर द ट्विटर, वन एपीआई कॉल फॉर गूगल क्लाउड नेचुरल लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग एपीआई। सो वी नीड ट्विटर ट्वीट्स टू गेट द डिस्कशन हैपनिंग ऑन अ टॉपिक एंड द नेचुरल लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग एपीआई टू अंडरस्टैंड द सेंटिमेंट ऑफ द ट्वीट्स। Google Cloud platform is used because we are using a set of tools from them for the APIs. Twitter API, as mentioned, we are using. Actions on Google is what we're dealing to build, and Dialogflow is a service which integrates all this. Dialogflow is like the equivalent of a ID for voice assistant. So we do code development on VS Code or some other IDs. So Dialogflow is the equivalent of that for voice assistants. So we need to do some pre-workshop agenda to get the API keys and set up everything. So let us see how it is done. So the first step is to create a Google Cloud project. I suppose all of you have a Google account. Else you can create. There's one thing that I want to okay. So I'll send this link in the call chat. This is something which is suspended temporarily, but once this comes back up, you all can click on access benefits. And you can get Google Cloud credits, which you can use even without having a debit card or any billing account. This is something which students are eligible for. This is temporarily on hold, but this will come back. So without that, we can't use the natural language processing API. So in this entire flow that we are following, there's just one major segment which is using the Google Cloud billing, because that is a paid API. In case you are going to not use that and want something else, there is another API, sentiment analysis by Azure. And yes, this is the API. This API is free of cost, and not just that, in Azure you can get the credits without any hassle using your institute mail ID. So you can use any APIs you want for development. For today's workshop, we are using the Google Cloud Natural Language Processing API. This Azure's API is also very similar. You just need to change the API endpoint in the code and it would work. In case you want this, I'll send that also in chat. Microsoft API is easy to set up for students since it does not require a billing account. So we'll be using Google Cloud because a major chunk of the project is already in Google Cloud. So integrating it becomes a bit easy. So how do we create a Google Cloud project? First is you need to go to console.cloud.google.com. Click on the dropdown. You can create a new project. It will ask you names and details, and then you are good to go. I have one created just few minutes ago. I'm using it. Make sure that the right project is selected in the dropdown, and we are ready. So we have the Google Cloud project ready. Let's see what the next step is. This is how it looks when the program comes back. You can get $50 worth of credits valid for 1 year using your institute mail address. On hold, as mentioned, we have created a project as well, and then we need the natural language processing API. This API is what we are going to use. Okay. So let us cloud natural language API. So we go you can either go to API and services dashboard and find the API, or you can directly click on the search bar on the top and type it. Let me type is cloud API. Cloud natural language API. So this was the API that we needed. Click on it by doing enable API. It takes few minutes, and then it should be, yes, the API is enabled, so it should be good to go. This billing enabled did not pop up for me because I had it enabled for the project. So when you do, this will come up, and this is where you need a billing account. So in case you don't have a billing account or a free credits, you can use the Microsoft API, which is free as of now for students, and you can skip this step. Now let's go back to Dialogflow. Dialogflow is the place where we're going to build our ID, going to build our voice assistant. So we need to go to console.actions.google.com. If you want, I can send that also in the chat. Once we come over here, we click on new project. Since we already have created a project on Google Cloud, this is pretty much linked, so all the projects show up. The one that is showing an yellowish one are the Firebase project, and the hexagon ones are the Google Cloud projects. So what we need is Google Assistant Twitter, because that is the name of the project that you see on over here. So we do that. We click on import project. Okay. Wait a few seconds, inputs, and yeah, it's imported. Now let's see what the next steps are. We have done this, and this also. What we need to do is build a conversation, right? So we click on custom conversation components and then start building.
There's a question in the chat box.
Yes, we will be having the recording and the presentation sent over to you so that you can develop it later as well. I understand this is a session where we can't do code along because it requires two APIs, which one of them requires a billing account, which some students don't have. And the second API that we are using is Twitter's API, which usually takes around 15, 20 minutes for approval, or sometimes it takes a few days as well. So yes, if you want, you can code along, or else you can directly watch the replay. And we'll also send the slides to all the people who have registered over here. Make sense, Kabir? Yeah, perfect. Yeah, so we were over here. So what we want to know is how our action gets invoked. Like, we have one voice assistant on the entire phone, and we ask it something, what's the weather? It knows that it's an action which is managed by Google internally, and that is what is triggered. We say send a WhatsApp message, and it knows that it is supposed to trigger an action built by WhatsApp. So the first step we need to know is these all are invocations. So we need to set up how our action is going to get invoked when someone says something to the voice assistant. So we should set that up and decide how your action is invoked. Display name, this is the name of the action. We can give sentiment analyzer. This is the default voice assistant voice that comes for your action. And you can click save. Saved successfully. Okay, great. Then we go to the actions tab on the left under the build section, and we are going to add our first action. Intense. Just develop invocation. Did we do invocation? Yes. Let me open it once again. Build your action. Okay, let me show you how to open the once you click on test, you should be able to have a simulator of voice assistant. Okay, wrote some error for me. It should ideally work. Let me try running it once again. Once you do that, you should have a voice assistant running in the browser. Requirement failed. Okay, let me so while it happens, let me explain how it happens. So we have done the terms acceptable apart. Let it build the preview. It should not take much time. Ideally, you should use the Chrome browser because it has some issues with other browsers. I'm not using Chrome. Maybe that is the issue. Yeah, so it is, deployment is failing. Yeah. Ideally, you should try using Chrome because sometimes it causes issue with some browsers. So once we have done that, we need to do a linking between the APIs that we have. So for that, we are going to create an intent. So intent is like subsections of a voice assistant. So it's like you can have one entire action, let's say for WhatsApp. So it can even send messages. It can find out a list of WhatsApp users or anything you want. So all those can be combined into one action. And each individual things those actions do are classified into intents. Okay. So in intents, there are two default intents. One is a default fallback intent, and one is the default welcome intent. Welcome intent is the welcome message when the intent is triggered. And the default fallback is when you tell it something and the voice assistant is not able to understand it. So it is something along the lines of, sorry, I could not get you, could you repeat? So these all fallbacks intents are configured automatically in Google Cloud. So these two are automatically configured. If you want to add your own, you can add it. So you click on create intent, name, give it a name you want, and then save. Once that is done, this looks like a complex step for those of you who know machine learning, which is known as training. So, but in Google Cloud, for the voice assistant, this training is really fast and quick. So the moment you add a few parameters, like these are the set of phrases you want it to respond to, the training happens fairly quick. So this could be some of the training phrases for the topic that we are building. Like, we want to know how people are feeling about a specific topic. So we can have, how do people feel about a parameter X? Or we can have, how do you feel about? So all those different phrases you can put over here, and the training will be done once you click the training button. This is something, since we want to trigger something from the response, we are going to use something known as variables. So once we do that, we are using this sys.any to do that for us. Any is used because the type of the variable can be anything. It can be a string, a URL, or something. So since we don't care about what type of data it is, it can even be number or string or anything, we can give the any data type. Next is adding response. So we need to add the response when the action has processed something and it wants to give a response. The response is not the fallback URL or the fallback intent. So if the action does not understand what you said, it goes to the fallback intent. But the response is when it understood and it has processed something and it wants to give the response back to the user. Once we add the set of responses as well, then we need something known as fulfillment. Fulfillment is a way in which you can have your action or intent have some link with the APIs. You can have your own server probably running something. So your voice assistant can query from the server using some APIs, and then it gives the response back. So for doing that, we need something known as fulfillment. So you go to the console and you enable fulfillment, and then you would be ready to roll. For this session, we have a code, which is a demo code for us, which helps us out. So let me show the code. This code is to be written in the console. I'll tell you how the code works. So this package.json is handled internally by the console to import all these packages that we need for this function to run. Let me explain how this function works. So the first, these four lines are for importing the packages that we have. We need to add our project ID here. So what our project ID is, let me show you. This Google Assistant Twitter is the project name. This is the ID. So you can create a project by this name, but this ID is going to be unique for everyone across the globe. So what they want is this project ID. So you copy this project ID and you can put it in line 12, line 14 to be precise. And then I'll explain the remaining chunk of the code once we get the Twitter API, because we need that. So let's go back to the slides. So this is what I told. We have the index.js file, which is what we need to copy and paste it in the console. This, as mentioned, this package.json file is used by the fulfillment section to import all these packages to be used by the function, like Dialogflow request. Request is used to do API calls. Google Cloud Language is the package which has the natural language processing API. So as mentioned, these are the four lines in the beginning which used to import the packages. Project ID, do remember about the project ID, that the project ID is not the project name. So if you put the project name, it won't work. Now let us see how are you going for Twitter API. So let me, you go to developer.twitter.com. You open it in incognito. There will be an option to apply for it on the top right. It's asking for login. So once you log in, you should be able to apply. I have applied and I have it. Let me send that link also in chat. For those applying for Twitter APIs, do remember that it will ask a set of questions, which is kind of like this. How are you going to use the APIs? What all analysis are you going to do with the APIs? Are you affiliated with any government agency or not? Set of standard questions, and once it's approved, you will get a mail. So do fill it out. It usually takes few hours for them to approve it. So in case, even if there's some issue with your application, they will respond via mail and you can reply back to them and they'll approve it. Once you submit, it was earlier, a few years ago, they had instant approval, but now, since a lot of developers are using Twitter's APIs, these APIs are as of now on request basis only. Let me show you how to get the Twitter API set up. So you go to developer.twitter.com. I am using the Hack NITR Hackathon's Twitter account, for which we had applied for API key and we had got it. So we go to developer.twitter.com, go to developers portal once you have it, and then you go to, first you go to apps. You can create a new app. I have already created one. Let me show you how it is done. This app name has to be unique. You can give description, a website URL. This website URL is required because when you apply for Twitter's API, you would have given a website. So they want to know where this Twitter API is going to be used. So if you don't have a website, you can probably give your GitHub repo link or something. But yeah, they do require a website. You can even give your repo's URL. This is to know if you are enabling sign with Twitter option in the app, which you are not using in this project as of now. So once you fill that up, you can click create. Once you have done that, you will be having an app created on Twitter. And once you open it, in the keys and token section, you will have the API keys. These are the API keys that are being used to have the API calls done. So since I've done that, I need to click on regenerate for that. So once that is done, let's see what the next steps are. So as mentioned, these are the set of questions they ask. Are you using Twitter to analyze or do some surveillance, which is not according to their policies? So be mindful of the policies. Also, using Twitter API for levels of automation is not allowed. So basic retweeting using bots is allowed. So make sure that whatever the information you're filling is not violating the policy that they have. So once we get the keys, what we need to do is we need to replace the keys in our code. Let me show the code. Yeah. This is the endpoint we are using, which is known as 30-day. So it retrieves the tweets on a given topic from the last 30 days. This is the API URL, which is already pre-filled for us. These are the two places where we need to fill the keys. The key that I showed you. Just a second, give me just a second. I'm getting a call, just a second. I'm audible now? I suppose I am.
Yes.
Yeah. So let me explain what this line 19 does. This is known as Twitter environment for the app. So you can have a testing environment. You can have a deployment environment. So how do you do that? So you go to your username on the developer console, scroll down, and you see dev environments. Click on it and you can set up a dev environment. I have already done that. And the name of the environment is testing. If you put a different name, you will have to change it over here. So make sure that this line 19, the environment name matches the environment label that you have given so that it can query using the environment variable that you have. We are using the search tweets for 30 day sandbox. So it searches tweets from the last 30 days and gives it back to you. For those of you who want to do this without having to use Twitter's APIs, there's a service which you can check out. That's Twint. Twint is a Twitter scraping service, which does not require APIs, and it does awesome. Majority of it is in Python. So if you can have your own server doing what this Twitter's API is doing, having a Python server do the entire thing. So, and it works really good. So even that is one alternative way in case you don't want to use Twitter's API directly. So this is the part that I mentioned. We set up the dev environment. And once that is done, and this is the name that I was telling you. This name has to pass the line in the code because else the environment won't match. Line 19. So let us see what all we have done as of now. We have created a GCP account and created a project, which is where our entire project is. Like even the dialogue flow project that we have is part of Google Cloud itself. We have created a Twitter developer account. This is used to have access to Twitter's API through which we can get the tweets on a given topic last 30 days. And we need to add the credentials from the app that we put the key of the API into the code that we have. When you are deploying it, since it is in Google Action, you can directly put the keys. But if you are hosting it on GitHub, it is recommended that if you are ever pushing your code to GitHub, it is recommended that you don't put the keys in the GitHub directly in a public repo. So be mindful of that. So let us understand what each of the section of the code does. This filtered retweets is the way how Twitter works is that even a retweet is a tweet. It's just one different type of tweet, but it's even a tweet. So this part is used to filter the tweets. And if a retweet exists, so we add it to the list of arrays that we have. This is the part where we extract the text from the tweet. So a tweet has multiple values, like who tweeted is, when was it tweeted, number of retweets, number of likes. So among all those parameters, what we want is the text from the tweet. So this is what this code is doing. And then we are going to start an intent. This line 67 that it says app.intent. So it is using the sentiment intent that we had created. So in case you remember, we had created a sentiment intent. So we are using that intent in this code so as to reference it. So we are using Twitter's APIs. So this is the part that I mentioned, this consumer key and this consumer secret. This we had put in a variable in the initial lines. So we are referencing it in over here. This is the standard HTTP request library of JavaScript. Whatever we are doing, we are using JavaScript because it has an inbuilt JavaScript runtime for actions. So you don't need to set up any server to do this. All this code runs in the action itself when you trigger it, because it has got its own JavaScript runtime. So the first step that we are doing is we are requesting the Twitter's API to give us a response of all the tweets. Once that is done, we are sending the tweets that we have got into the sentiment analysis API that we have. It provides a result which is in a range of positive to negative numbers. So depending on how it is, we can identify what the sentiment is. So this is the metric that it has been set. You can even set a different score if you want. So from 0 to 0.1, it has set people have mixed feelings. If the sentiment that it responds is less than 0, it clearly means that people feel negatively about. How it works is it has got internal machine learning models which understands how people's language is processed and understood. So if people are like happy about a given topic, it gives higher values. Or if people are angry or sad about it, it gives a negative value. This conversation.close, the method that we are calling, is used to close the conversation that we are having with the Google Assistant. So once a user has asked how a person feels about a given topic, so once the has responded, we are closing the conversation. So if a user wants to start again, he'll have to ask once again. So once that is done, there's the deployment of your assistant to Google Assistant so that everyone can get it across the globe is something which is not instant. So you can click on deploy and then fill up the form, fill up the terms and conditions and apply for it. Once you have done that, you need to set up everything as well regarding what your starting intent is and everything is. Once you have done that and it is approved, you should have your Google Assistant deployed and you should have it available to all the users, including your phone. This is the simulator that I was mentioning, which could not be loaded on my end due to some reasons. So once you have even basic Hello World setup, you can have the simulator, which works exactly the same like any mobile's voice assistant. So you can, all the questions that you can ask on the voice assistant, you can work over here as well, as like what's the weather or something. And it also has your development environment as well. So even when the Google Assistant that you're developing is not deployed, you can test it in this simulator that we have. So this is how it would look once we have done it. So we ask it, how do people feel about, let's say, IPL or something along those lines. So it would respond back, people have mixed feelings or feel positively or they feel negatively about a given topic. So this was the welcome intent that I was saying. This all right, getting the test version of sentiment analyzer. Talk to sentiment analyzer assistant is the invocation command, invoke our action. same way that we have sent a WhatsApp message to send something on WhatsApp or play a Spotify music for playing a music on Spotify. So this is the invocation action. And as you can see, with really less amount of setup and code, we can develop something which can be deployed to Google Assistant with seamless integration of all the APIs that we want. If you all have any questions or concerns to ask, feel free to ask, because I understand this has been a workshop in which we can't code along because majority of you don't have access to the APIs. It takes time for the APIs to get approved. So this recording will be up on our YouTube channel for you to watch it. In case you have any questions, if you get stuck or anyways, please feel free to ask on the Slack channel that we have so that we can help you out. Smara can send the Slack invite link on chat. This is a fun quiz which you all can fill out so that to check how well you understood the topics. Let me put the link in chat. Anyone have any questions? Thank you all for attending. I hope you have understood the basics of how it works. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in chat or unmute yourself and do regarding the workshop or regarding any topic you want to ask. I'll put the Slack invite link also in chat. I assume you don't have any questions as of now. Thank you all for joining. I hope you have a wonderful evening and you stay safe. We'll be having a workshop tomorrow and in the upcoming weekends as well. Once again, thank you for joining. If you have any questions, I'll be around for a few more seconds in case you want to ask. Smarak, you can stop the recording.